The Moscone Center project is a complete transformation of the Moscone Convention Center. And it is not only an addition and an increased space, but it also is a really interesting transformation of the urban neighborhood around it in a positive way.
It's the 25th largest convention center in the country, but these conventions are getting bigger and bigger and need more space. So with this expansion, it will be the 13th largest.
We're currently under construction. We've been under construction for the last year and a half, and we're set to complete construction by December of 2018. Tourism is one of San Francisco's most important industries. In fact, it generates over $9 billion of spending annually in San Francisco.
35% of all visitors who come to San Francisco are people coming to conventions and meetings at the Moscone Center.
We anticipate about 2,500 permanent jobs will be created as a result of the expansion once the building reopens.
If we didn't do this expansion, we would lose about $200 million in taxes a year. Many of those conventions are talking about going to other cities where they have ample ballroom, ample exhibit space, and not come to San Francisco.
We've had pressure to relocate. There's a lot of push to go to a city like Las Vegas. We're at a point now where our exhibition floor is broken up into two halves of the Moscone. And really, you know, I think what our attendees want, what we desire is just one contiguous space.
We're adding significant additional space, about 300,000 square feet additional gross area. We are first connecting the two existing north and south exhibition halls below grade by excavating under Howard Street to increase from right now the largest exhibition space is 260,000 square feet to make one contiguous space of over 500,000 square feet.
The very spot I'm standing in will be inside the Moscone Center lobby. The building actually will be pushed out to the street, to Howard Street, and will be connected both north and south, above ground and underground.
Once you go down either on the north side or the south side, you have descended or entered into one large exhibition hall, which can be divided up in many different ways.
This is a public-private partnership. The hotel industry voted for a self-assessment to contribute to this construction of a city-owned building. The hotel industry and the city are basically splitting the costs of this building.
Since we do have a north and south side of Howard Street, it was very, very important to find ways to make connectivity happen.
We're improving the bridges to make them more accessible that goes over Howard Street.
So we wanted to make these bridges really part of the public realm. The light bridge is in fact, physically very light. A selection panel was developed to look at several different proposals for a light artist to work with that bridge. And the selection resulted in Leo Villarreal. He's done what I think is a very beautiful piece that is very animated. You'll be able to see it as a convention goer as you walk across the bridge, and you can see it as a resident of San Francisco looking up at it itself. There is a second bridge, and this bridge actually replaces an existing bridge over Howard Street that links Yerba Buena Gardens to a children's playground by replacing the above grade bridge. Is to make a much larger public space as well as a civic plaza space that brings you up to that in a very visible way.
We worked on the design of the playground to make it a safe and inviting area for the families. We also added about 8,000 square feet of open space.
The whole area will be more connected with the neighborhood, so you don't have to be at a meeting in Moscone to enjoy it. You can also walk by, have a picnic lunch in the park outside, and it's going to be a much better space for everyone.
Light is such a critically fundamental part of architecture. In fact, it could be even thought of as equivalent to columns and beams in a building of that level of importance. We have placed all of the pre-function areas, the areas that you walk to, that you check in prior to entering into ballrooms and meeting rooms. We pulled all those activities to the very face of the building as opposed to burying them inside. So wherever we possibly can, we found ways to bring light into these occupied spaces, including skylights and these glass areas along the street. This building is really designed to target the very highest level of LEED environmental performance, which is the platinum level. All the steel in this building is recycled steel. The concrete used in the building uses recycled materials as well. The big part of it too is the water.
We will be harvesting all of the rainwater and the storm water and reusing it.
In burying these exhibition halls, they actually extend down into the aquifer level of the water level, which means that water is constantly being pumped out to relieve this pressure. And there are over 15 million gallons of water per year that Moscone Center pumps out into the city's stormwater system. So water is essentially wasted. So our idea is to disconnect the groundwater system from the stormwater system and rather use that water to save it, preserve it, and use it for internal operations of the building, like toilet flushing, for example, and use it for other irrigation kinds of uses. And we calculate that we even have enough excess water to even fill up street cleaning trucks to clean the streets around the neighborhood.
There will be some limited traffic impact during construction.
There will be about an 8-month period where we'll have to take a lane of traffic from Howard Street so that we can expand the tunnel and improve the bridge.
We anticipate the disruption to be minimal in the neighborhood.
The expansion definitely will help our attendees, you know, facilitate that networking, meet each other.
This expansion is going to make Moscone Center state-of-the-art in technology, and it's also going to make it much more competitive nationally and internationally.
The part of the expansion I'm most excited about is having that contiguous space, having North and South join underneath Howard, having Esplanade build up and having more classrooms there.
This has been a true process where we've really worked with the residents, the merchants in the neighborhoods, the nonprofits, to make sure that this is a vibrant area.
Even if you're not coming to a convention at Moscone, you can enjoy the public space because of the improvements that's happening. It's something that's going to help revitalize the neighborhood, bring energy to the neighborhood, bring more people to the neighborhood, more people to the shops, the retail, and really showcase San Francisco around the world.